Into Chaos, Chaos55T here, and welcome back to Shitty Pasta Reading. And today I'm gonna read The Pasta That Smashes Mouths. I'm starting to feel like somebody doesn't know the gimmick of a creepypasta trademark. My friends once told me that creepypastas were poop. The confusion that I felt was like the world was gonna roll me. I started discussing with him that I knew that I ain't wrong. The rage made me turn into the sharpest tool in the shed. She was always stating that creepypasta's trademark were cool. I was looking at her, kind of felt dumb, but smart at the same time. With her finger and her thumb, I made her point at herself. I tried to make it seem like it was in the shape of an L on her forehead. Nah, I'm just kidding. This isn't the shitty pasta that we're reading today. As you can tell by the title, the shitty pasta that we're reading is He Was on the Side of the Road. Once upon a time, I was driving along an interstate in the middle of the United States. I forgot which state it was, but it was scary. With dense trees on both sides of the road, I have my brights on and was driving on the interstate. A bit scared, but I was in my car, so I assumed I was safe. That was until I saw something reflecting off of my headlights and distance far away. I began to get scared. Over time, slowly, the object got bigger and bigger, and eventually I realized to be a person. As I got closer, still began to see details. He was wearing an old suit, average height, white hair, glasses, and looked pretty old. I felt as if I recognized him, but I couldn't put my finger on it. Before I knew it, he stuck out his thumb and I slammed on my brakes. The car came to a screeching stop, and then the man came into my car. It was Alex Tribbick.
Where are you headed?
I asked him.
To my apartment, he said to me.
So I drove down the interstate and saw a building in the distance. It was a medium size, and Tribbick told me that it was it. It was only a few miles from where I found him. I stepped in front of it, and it was a shitty motel with a few rundown rooms and a blinking neon sign. Then Alex told me thank you. I asked for his autograph, and he just walked away to his room, ignoring me. I sigh and then drive away back into the foresty interstate. I drove for another hour or two, then I saw a note on my dashboard. It says,
"Look in the glove box!"
I'm too scared to look in there. Did he put a bomb, gun, signature? I don't know what to do with guys, but I'm so scared. I called cops, but they did nothing, so I am stumped. By the way, thank Alex for letting me pick you up. It was pretty cool.
What? In the hell did I just read? Well, it's a shitty pasta. What do you expect?
This is Chaos55T, signing out.